Press officer Zachary Hippolyte highlighted procedures that must be followed when it comes to moonlighting services or private security services. The first requirement is for permission to be obtained in order to perform such services. Mr. Hippolyte made it clear that the officer who got stabbed by bandits while performing cash escort services at Caribbean cinemas did follow the procedures. Nonetheless, the incident throws the moonlighting issue back into the spotlight.
They come to Chesterfield, the police headquarters, where they will be given an application form. And they will also be given a document entitled Employer's Agreement to Conditions of Police-Related Off-Duty Employment. And this document highlights at least 12 conditions in which the police officer may operate under in terms of this off-duty unemployment. And also on the reverse side of this document, there is the employer's indemnity agreement. So the police officer and the potential employer will sign this document.
According to Mr. Hippolyte, there is a form that must be filled both by the employer and the police officer. The document makes it abundantly clear that officers ought to conduct their private duties in uniform unless permitted by the police commissioner to do otherwise.
For example, when you look at number 11 states, officers who are engaging in police-related or other special off-duty employment are required to carry their police-issued service weapon or off-duty weapon authorized by the Commissioner of Police.
Mr. Hippolyte also called for more lighting at the Caribbean Cinema's car park, as the dark areas, according to him, are providing a haven for the criminal elements. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas.